Now we are talking about the motion function, velocity, acceleration, and the connection between these three. Motion function is s at t, you have it here. V at t is velocity, a at t is acceleration. What is the connection between them? Derivative of the motion function is velocity. Derivative of the velocity is acceleration. That means that if you differentiate motion function first, you will get velocity. If you differentiate it second time, you will get acceleration. So second derivative of the motion function is acceleration. Now, here is the example. Given function, motion function, you need to find velocity function, acceleration function, velocity at the point t equals 3, and acceleration at the point t equals 3. So let's do it. Velocity is derivative of s. So let's differentiate s. You will get 5 from here, 3t squared. From 4t, you will get just 4. Derivative of 9 is 0. 5 times 3 will give you coefficient 15, that is here, t squared plus 4. Then you need to evaluate velocity at 3. So plug in 3 to this expression. 3 squared will give you 9. So altogether, the value will be 139. The given units are meters and seconds, so it's going to be meters per second. After that, you need to do acceleration. Acceleration function is derivative of velocity. Velocity is right here. Let's differentiate 15t squared. You will get 15 times 2t. 15 times 2t. Derivative of constant is 0, so nothing is in here. Multiply coefficients, you will get 30 times time. And after that, the last question is acceleration at 3. Plug in 3 for the argument of the function a at t. 30 times 3 will give me 90, and the units are meters per second squared.